keeping myself so busy. Personal, the misery. Trying to find the peace in me.
Hello guys and welcome back to GotSpeed. Today we have the all new Hyundai Venue with us. So first of all, as what we usually do, let's open the hood and see what's below the hood. So below the hood you get three engine options. Now this one is the 1.4 litre diesel 3RDI engine producing 90 bhp and 220 Nm of torque. So quite good power figures. This is the turn indicator and you get split headlamps, and below them is the DRL with projector setup and halogen. You also get cornering headlamps. Now you got projector fog lights over here as well. So lighting is quite good. This is the bold grille with blackened out chrome and a very big Hyundai logo. Below them is the air dam and silver skid plates. So the body lighting and skid plates add to the looks of the car. And you see, you get very stylish headlights. You get split headlights and they have a good amount of vision. And the hood is also quite heavy and long. Yes, this car has a lot of SUV appeal. Coming to the tires, so the tires are dual spoke and dual tone alloy wheels. The size of the tires is 215 by 60 R16 inch tires with disc brakes at the front and drum brakes at the back. You can see ground clearance also quite good and body cladding has been done all around the car to give it a SUV appeal. This is the rear view mirror with turn indicators in this C shape over here, and these actually look very stylish when you look from the side. Now you get retro sensors for diverse identity, and this is the chrome handle and opens as a hole. You can see it opens as a hole. All the handles are the same. Again, you'll see you get drum brakes at the back. Now these are the roof rails with black inserts, and these are silver roof rails. Now I don't think these are functional, but yes, these add up to the looks of the car. And because of the others, the car looks quite good from this side. But yes, this car is a sub 4 meter compact SUV. Now you also get a rear wiper over here. These are the rear tail lamp with turn indicators. Below over here is the reversing light with rear reflectors. Again, you can see silver skid plates with your number plate back can be hung over there. Skid plates and body cladding done all over the car. This is the top of the line SX Plus variant. Let's open the boot and check out the amount of space you get. So you get 350 liters of boot space, and over here is a spare wheel. This is a steel wheel, and the size of the steel wheel is 165 by 65 R15. So cost cutting over here. This is not a full size wheel. A triangle has been kept over here. This is the parcel tray, and from here you can close the boot like this. So you can see Hyundai and Hyundai Venue badging done over here. See Hyundai Venue badging done over here. This is the rear sprinkler. This is the braking light and a shark fin antenna over there. So overall, this car looks very much stylish and in person looks very good. So let's open the rear door of the car. So this is the rear door. You get leather stitching over here, and this is black leather. Door pockets are small, only 1 liter bottle can be kept. Speakers on the doors, silver door handles. Now again, as usual, this is the maximum legroom you can get, and that is the minimum legroom. Let's sit with the maximum legroom on offer. And you can see space is quite good and quite impressive. A lot of space is on offer, and 3 people can easily sit inside. The car is not that wide, but yes, 3 people can sit, and they might feel uncomfortable. You also get rear AC vents with the silver inserts, a 12 volt charging socket. AC can be closed or turned on from here. Magazine holders over here, but no magazine holder has been placed on the driver's side door after seat. This is the holder, and a central light has been placed over here. You also got a central and electrical adjustable sunroof, and this is the armrest. So let's open the rear armrest first. So this is the armrest with twin cup holders, and the seats are leather seats, and you also get ISOFIX child seat mount. You also get rear seat belts. The rear headrests are adjustable. You can fold the seats from here. There is 60-40 split on offer. You can fold the seats in 60-40 split ratio. You can see stitching done on the door on over here, and even the seats. This give the car a very premium feel. Now over here there is a transmission tunnel hump, so the middle passenger quite will not feel that uncomfortable, but yes, this is quite large enough. Again, so rear seat experience is quite good. Even when the seat is pushed all the way behind, let us sit over there and see. So when the seat is pushed all the way behind, even then the space on offer is quite good. I have ample amount of space below the seat to stretch my feet. So three people might not be that comfortable over here, but it's not a bad idea to seat three people. Under thigh support is also quite good. The only problem I face is with the knee room, or the leg room you can say. That even at idle positions, the knee room might not be the greatest, but when it is a sub 4 meter compact SUV, you get, this is the maximum leg room you can get in the segment. The window panels are not that great, not that small, so some people might feel claustrophobic, but for me, the windows are quite okay. You sit high above the car and you get a wide view of what's happening outside. Doors can be locked or unlocked like this. You can see these can be locked. This is the unlock button. Now that's the dashboard, and now let's get over there. Now let's get to the driver's side door. So let us go to the driver's side door and see the features you put on offer. So let's open the driver's side door. Oh, this is the driver's side door. Again, you can see stitching done over here. The bottle holder again, and the door pocket also not that much large. Now this is the controls for your windows, controls lock and unlock the car. This is to adjust the mirrors. Now you get two tweeters in the front. Let's just sit over here. Now the doors close the thud, that means the build quality is quite good. This is the key of the vehicle, and you get four buttons to lock, unlock, to open the boot, and to press the horn of the car. Just keep the key over here. This is the place, this is place to keep the keys. You get a factory fitted air purifier, which occupies one of your bottle hold cup holders. You get two twin cup holders over here, and one of them is occupied by this air purifier. You get a handbrake, and below the handbrake also you get some storage space. You get a wireless charger, that's the first in segment. A USB charging port, a USB charging port over here as well, and a USB port over here. So no off cable can be found right now. This is the wireless charging port. This is the 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system, and all these are the buttons related to your touchscreen system. You get automatic ACs, some storage space above the glove box. Let's open the glove box and check the amount of space you get. So the glove box might not be the biggest, but yes, you can keep a lot of stuff inside. So over here is the button to turn on and off the traction control, then the button for your start stop system, and then this is for the headlight leveling. Now let's just start the car in ignition and check the systems. So this is the instrument cluster with the speed of 220 km per hour with the highest speed. Dashboard might not seem the longest, but yes, it's quite good. Your silver inserts around the AC vents, the headlight control are over here, and the control for the wipers are placed over here. Over here is the control for your cruise control, and over here is the control related to your infotainment system. So this is the 6-speed gearbox, and this is the center armrest. It can be adjusted and it can also be opened like this. And there's a deep space below which you can keep your other stuffs. Now this is the AC control. You got automatic ACs, and the display is over here. Just show you the display once. You can see the display. The AC cools the car quite fast enough, so the cooling of the AC is quite good, and you get automatic ACs. This is the MID display you get over here, which shows the driving information. And the best part about I like is this even shows you if your sunroof is open or if your boot is open. Even if your hood is open, this will remind you that the hood is open. So attention to detail done by Hyundai is quite good, and this is one of the best products in the segment. Now this is the electrically adjustable sunroof. Let us just open the sunroof once. The sunroof can be opened from here. To manually close the shutter. So a light has been placed on both the sides, which can be turned on like this as well. The connected info infotainment system. This is the also first in segment. You can talk to the car actually. This is you cannot access the map right now because there's no SD card present in this. So overall, this is a very good system and very much responsive. You can see this is very much responsive and has all these settings. Let's go to settings right now. So settings has all the general settings: voice recognition, sound advance, device connection, navigation, blue link, general and the display settings. Got a 3-spoke steering wheel with silver inserts over here. And you get silver inserts around all the AC vents, and you can see this continuity design over here. More safety features: you get 6 airbags, ABS, ESP, EBD. So even safety is quite good in this car, and this is overall a very great package. The car, the price of the car is around 12.3 lakhs onward Ahmedabad. And yes, this car is very good in terms of safety features and power as well. Above you get the auto dimming rear view mirror with the blue link system. You also get rear parking cameras. So overall, this is a very great package. You get 6 airbags, ABS, EBD. As I've already told you, that even safety is quite good in this car. Now, since this car is new, now let's wait for the comparison between this and the EcoSport, because that is the main car which is on the same price. So guys, if you like the video, do hit the like button and subscribe to GotSpeed for most of the videos, and do follow us on Instagram for regular car updates. I will see you guys soon in the next video. Goodbye.